Good afternoon, students. Welcome in video lecture of Employability and Skill Development. In this, we are discussing the unit number 6, Problem Solving Technique Use. Today, we are going to discuss the point Problem Solving Model. Already, from this unit, I discussed the brief introduction about the Problem Solving Technique. Now, in this Problem Solving Model, here it is considered that this particular problem solving model, it addresses the many challenges which is arised at the workplace, that may be in your organization, any office or any place. Here regularly people are trying to solve the problems with having the ranges of different approaches and which is used to find out the solution. But the major complex challenges for the teams, or you can say that those who are working on this particular challenging problems and the boards are usually solved more quickly by using a shared, or you can say that collaborative and systematic approach to problem solving. This is, you can say that, one of the challenges, because here what we are considering that problem can be shared with the people or group members, then collaboratively all should be work on that particular problem, some systematic approach should be there, and by considering that, that problem can be solved. That is the one concept it is considered for this particular problem solving model. Here if you are considering this particular problem solving model, in that if you are considering this some steps, or you can say stages, then it is said that it will be more effective to solve that particular problem. So here one I shown one, you can say that one figure, in that how the problem it is can be solved one, right? That means problem solving model, how it is work one. It provides the consistency, it encourages the collaborative teamwork, idea for the complex problem as easy to repeat steps, then it process continuous for the improvement. You can use this whatever the process you are involved with, that you can consider for the continuous improvement, right? Such a, you can see that you are considering steps, or you can say that stages, then that problem will be solved easily, and whatever the difficulty arises during that solution or solving that particular problem, it can be again discussed one, it can be again some additional solution implemented one, and the problem, it can be solved some sort of the in a proper manner. So by considering this concept, here the problem solving model, it has basically 6 steps. First one is the defining the problem. Second one is the gather information related to that problem. Third one is the identify various solutions. Fourth one is the evaluate alternatives. Fifth one is the take action on that particular problem by considering the solution. Then sixth one is the evaluate the action, that means whatever the action you are taken, then whether it is getting good result or not, that means in the form of feedback you have to evaluate one. So these are the some of the steps which is involved, which is you can say that considered to get the effective that result from this particular model. So today we are going to discuss 1, 2, 3, that means steps 1, 2, 3, defining the problem, gathering gather the information, identify various solutions. These 3 steps we are going to discuss under this problem solving model, and remaining, that means fourth, fifth and sixth model, we will see in the next video lecture. So we will see one by one these 3, first 3. Under the problem solving model, first model is the, or first step you can say that is the define the problem. See, define the problem, it is nothing but you are diagnosing that particular problem. See, whenever you are considering any problem, then that problem you have to understand. We have to see which kind of a problem is there, and for that we have to do the diagnosing of that particular problem. That may be in the form of the context, background, that means the exactly the problem of background, its symptoms, all of the issues, all these things you have to diagnose one. You have to find out that particular thing, and then we have to define the exact the definition of that particular problem, right? Once this particular group, it is clear, or it is clear to grasp what exactly problem is, and then they investigate that particular wider symptoms to discover the implications of the problem, and who it affects on this particular problem, how urgent and important it is to resolve the symptoms. This thing will be, you can see that done by that particular, you can see that group. That means whenever you are considering any problem, at that time that particular group member from that workplace, they have to identify, that means they have to work on that particular problem, which kind of a problem is there, and they have to see the exactly the which kind of a problem it is there. They have to grasp that particular clear concept of that particular problem, then only they can, you can say that they will work on that particular problem. So the first step, it is very important one. So here I just drawn one figure, or that chart I presented here. That means defining the problem in the sense diagnosing, then its content, context, its background, its symptoms, like that you have to consider one, and accordingly you have to define that particular problem. Okay, now next step after the definition of that particular problem is that gather the information. See, once you gone through the exactly problem which is you are got, that maybe that team members or that group, they have got one, and once they gone through that particular problem, then they have to consider the exactly the symptoms which are found in that particular problem, and the whatever the concept of that particular problem diagnosed one, they have to consider, and an initial definition they have to agree one, right? And then they have to gather the information related to that particular problem. That means due to which cause that problem it is occurred one. What the exact reason behind that particular problem is there, right? Related to that, they have to gather the information, right? That will be help them to identify the solution, or you can say that whatever the definition is, it is considered, depending on that, if they are gathering the information, right, then they will get some sort of the easy way to consider the exactly the problem type and giving the solution for that. So after the first step, they have to gather the information related to that particular problem by considering the its cause, its reason, and what the action it requires. Like that, they have to find out exactly, you can see that clear information by observing, by considering that definition, right, and by considering its category, all these things they have to consider. And for that particular finding out the information or gathering out the information, they have to follow some sort of the, or they have to use some sort of the tools which are called as the fishbone diagram or Pareto analysis, affinity diagrams. Like that, they have to use some sort of the tools which will help them to collect the information, which will help them to collect this particular information in the form of, you can say, that structure, right? And they can focus on underlining cause of that particular problem, right? This process or this concept, it is called as the analysis of the root cause or gathering the information of that particular root cause. See here, just I given that particular structure here as the gathering information, that means considering the tools, fishbone diagrams, Pareto analyzing, and affinity diagrams, which will help them to find out the exact root cause of that problem. Okay, this is the second step. After the first and second step, that means understanding or defining the exactly the problem and its observation, its diagnosing, all that thing, its symptoms, all that thing, okay, you have to gather the information, and after the gathering the information, then you have to see the which kind of a solution it will consider for that particular problem. So here third step is the identify the various solution. See, the analytical or creative problem solving is about creating a variety of solution. It is not considering that only it is giving the only one, just one solution. It gives the variety of solution, right? That means by considering the problem, you have to consider the some sort of the n number of solution. Only one solution, it will not affect on that particular, you can see that it will not give that much result, that much, you can see, that effective solution. And for that, you have to consider the n number of solutions. So here, problem solving group, they will focus on the to find out the solution as the three things. Okay, first thing is that finding as many solutions to the problem, no matter how outlandish they may seem. That you don't consider that particular how it outlandish that may seem. You have to find out the n number of the solution for that problem. Second thing is the looking at how each solution relates to that particular root cause and that particular symptoms, right? How it is relates one, you have to consider that thing. And third one is the deciding if different solution can merge to give a better answer to the problem. That means by considering the n number of solution, you have to decide that if we are merging all the solution, which will give the better answer, right? That thing you have to consider. That means that group, you have to consider this thing. That means this group, they have to follow these focus, or they are, sorry, these points. They have to focus on these points so that they will give the, that means this will give the better result. So here, at this stage, it is not about the finding one solution, right? But eliminating the options that will prove the less effective and dealing the both of the symptoms and the root cause. That means here is the what we are doing. We are finding out the, we are considering that we have to find out the n number of solution. We are not considering only one solution, which will result on the poor performance, which will not give that much effective of that particular solution for the symptoms as well as that particular root cause. So we remember this particular thing. So here the chart, it shows how you have to follow that particular identifying the various solution is that generate as many as solution for the problems, assess how each solution relate to the root cause and symptoms, and decides if all you are merging instead of considering one solution. If you are considering all solution, then how it will give the best result, that thing you have to decide. So this is the, you can say, that third step which is considered for that particular problem solving model. So today that much we will discuss the thing. That means for the discussion I consider that much things, that means three steps. And if you are having any doubts related to these three things, you can ask me any time. And in the next video lecture, we will see the remaining three steps, so that you will get the exactly the what the problem solving model will, how it is working one. Because we are that means these particular models, it is considered in various organization, in various companies, so that they can work on that particular problem, and the teamwork, whenever they are working on that particular problem, it will easy to you can say that find out the solution, because different people are giving different ideas, and from that different ideas you will get the exactly the, you can see that you can merge the exactly solution for that particular problem. So communication, brainstorming things, it will be considered for this particular problem solving models, right? So we'll see the remaining three models in the next lecture. Thank you students, and go through these particular models and study well. Thank you once again.